Hey guys, I'm Joe, and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial. So today I'm going to take a look at the free transform mode, so let's go ahead and get started. So the free transform mode will allow you to scale, rotate, skew objects within Photoshop. So the first thing I need to do is I need to get an object into this document, and basically the easiest way for this example, I'm going to create a vector object. And to do this, I'm going to come over here to where the rectangle tool is, and based on the little arrow in the corner, there's more options, so I'll click and hold that, and you'll see there's some options here, but I'm looking for the custom shape tool. So now up here on the toolbar, we've got the option to choose a different vector object to bring in. You also have a gear icon that allows you to make a few changes or to kind of filter out this list if you're looking for something specific. I've just got all of the vector objects turned on. So we're going to go ahead and quickly just select an arrow and we'll put that onto the screen. So now we want to be able to transform this object that I just dropped onto the document. There's two ways to do this. The first one is to come up to the edit in the menu and select free transform. But we don't want to do that. That'll slow us down. We want to start learning some keyboard shortcuts. So to get into the free transform mode, you'll hit Command or Control T, and that'll put you into the free transform mode. So now we have a bounding box right here. And as you can see, my icon kind of changes based on where I put it. So inside the bounding box, it's a move icon, and that'll allow me to move it around. So if I move it outside, I get the rotation tool. And if I click and hold, I can rotate the object. Now, part of rotating, you have this little crosshair icon within the bounding box. So when I rotate, it is rotating based on this crosshair. So if I want to change the rotation anchor point, I just grab and drag that, and now when I go to rotate, now it's rotating on the anchor point. And if I want to move it back to the center, once I get close, it'll snap back into the center and we're rotating on center again. So let's talk about scaling now. So if I grab one of these middle points, it will scale horizontally or vertically depending on which one I grab. I also have the option to grab the corner ones and it'll scale both horizontally and vertically and not maintain the aspect ratio. So what if I want to maintain that aspect ratio? Well, there's a keyboard shortcut that'll allow you to do that. So if I hit Shift and then click on one of these corner icons, now it will only scale while maintaining the aspect ratio. Another keyboard shortcut is if I hold Control and grab one of these corners, it will allow me to skew the object. And if I want to undo the last change that I made, I can hit Control or Command Z, and it will undo the last change basically. So the shift and control options are basically perspective transforms, and there's a couple other perspective transforms. So if you don't want to necessarily memorize the hotkeys, you can right click inside the bounding box and you'll see a list of all the available options. So you got scale, rotate, skew, distort, perspective, warp, and then you've got a couple of just real quick transformations. So rotating at 180, clockwise and counterclockwise 90, flip it horizontal or vertical. So this will just allow you to do some quick actions without having to think about how to actually do those with the transform. So one of the other things that you can do is, say you know the numeric values that you want to set for transforming the object. So if you look up here, you have some options up here for controlling different values related to this object. So for example, if I click the W and I say 50, it just set the horizontal scale to 50%. Now, say I want to maintain the aspect ratio, there's a little icon here, and if I click that, now the ratio is maintained. So this is the other way, aside from shift click, you can actually constrain to where it doesn't matter how you're moving, it's always going to maintain that aspect ratio. Same with the angle. Say I want this to be at 45 degrees. I can type it in and now it's at 45 degrees. You also have the option, you'll see that the icon changed to kind of a slider icon. So if I click and I move left and right, you'll see that it's moving the angle. And I can do that for pretty much all of these options that that slider icon shows up for. So once you've got your object transformed the way you want, you have your confirm transform, which is this check box or hitting enter. Or if you don't want to complete the transform, you can cancel it by clicking this icon or hitting the escape key. So we're going to go ahead and keep these changes. And now it's been transformed. So that pretty much covers the free transform mode. It's a very helpful tool, and as you use Photoshop, you will probably find yourself using it very often, which is why I recommend using the hotkeys instead of the menu option to get into the free transform mode. So I hope this video was helpful, and if this is your first time, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And if you want to stay up to date on my latest videos, go ahead and hit the bell icon to receive notifications. Thanks, and we'll see you later.